Hello dear students, how are you doing?
I hope you'll be doing fine.
See, in our chapter we covered last, in last lecture we covered what? Basically we covered the calculation of number of atoms and molecules from the given mass of substance. We derived two formulas to calculate mole from the mass and to calculate mole from the number of particles, and we did the reverse thing also, that we calculated the number of particles, atoms and molecules from the given mass of a substance. In the last lecture I gave you a question, and the question was that you have to calculate the mass. You have to calculate the mass of CO2, which contains 3 into 10 to the power 23 oxygen atoms. So I will be teaching this thing to you today, but I just gave this question, so let you try that whether you can connect things or not. So let us discuss this question first, and then we will move on to this topic, that is calculation of mass from given number of atoms or particles. See, in this type of questions you have to do the reverse thing. What is the reverse thing? You have been given with number of oxygen atoms, correct? So what you will do is, you will first calculate, like there are two methods to do this question. One method is this. Let's say you can consider that you have x gram of CO2, correct? So what you will do here is, you will calculate number of atoms of oxygen in terms of x and then you will compare that value with the given number of oxygen atoms, because that will be the actual number of oxygen atoms you will be having in this unknown mass. So to calculate number of atoms here, first you have to calculate moles of CO2, which will be equal to x upon 44, correct? So x upon 44 moles CO2 you have. Now if you will multiply this by Na, then you will have x by 44 Na molecules of CO2, correct? And as you can see, in one CO2 molecule you have two oxygen atoms. So if you have two oxygen atoms in one molecule, then number of atoms will be equal to 2x upon 44 into Na, which is 6 into 10 to the power 23. This is the number of oxygen atoms according to me, and these are the number of oxygen atoms according to the question. So this cancels out this. You can calculate value of x from here. See, 3 2s are 4. This cancels out 11 times, so mass of CO2 will be equal to 11 grams, correct? This is method number one. You can also calculate this by another method. What is the another method? Let's see. You have that one molecule CO2. One molecule CO2 contains how much? It contains two oxygen atoms. So you can start from here, from number of oxygen atoms. You can calculate molecules of CO2. From molecules of CO2, you can calculate moles of CO2. And from moles of CO2, you can obviously get mass of CO2. So we are doing the reverse approach now. You have two oxygen atoms in one molecule of CO2. So I can simply say that one oxygen atom will be present in 1 by 2 molecule of CO2. Am I correct? Okay. Now you have this much number of oxygen atoms. So if one oxygen atom is present in half molecule of CO2, then your 3 into 10 to the power 23 atoms, these number of atoms will be present in 1 by 2 into 3 into 10 to the power 23 molecules of CO2. So from here you can get number of CO2 molecules, number of CO2 molecules, correct? How much it will be? It will be 3 by 2 into 10 to the power 23. From number of CO2 molecules, we can calculate number of moles. So to get number of moles from here, what we'll do? Yes, very good. We'll divide it by Na. So it will be equal to 3 into 10 to the power 23 upon 2 into 6 into 10 to the power 23. This cancels. So the number of moles will be equal to 1 by 4. And to get mass from moles, you have to multiply by the molar mass, and the answer would be 11 grams, correct? So these are two simple and conventional approaches which are used to calculate the mass of a substance from given number of atoms or molecules. Now, one thing, as we have covered two lectures, you should do the DPP number one, which I have given you, that is based on those topics which we covered in the last lectures, okay? So I'll be giving you some DPPs, some material, some questions for practice also. So you should do those questions. See, the most important part for learning physical chemistry is the application part. It's not about theory. someone will say you, or you must also consider this point also, like it will be in your mind that chemistry is all about mugging up things. No, it's not a simple theoretical subject. It's physical chemistry. It includes numericals, and you know numericals are not that much easy in physical chemistry. So you have to create a very good base to move up to solve numericals. So you are covering theory in here, but the most important part is doing question. I am giving you plenty of questions to practice these basic varieties. We will be filling the gap between basic questions and advanced level questions, higher level questions. So to fill that gap, you have to practice those DPPs which I am giving you. Okay. So let us move to the next part. As you have already solved this question, but I have a different method and a different approach which you should learn to solve these type of questions. This method will not only solve these type of questions, it will also include some other varieties of questions also. So stay focused and stay amazed. See, what this method is, if I say that I have one molecule of H2SO4, okay, I have one molecule, or let's say I have one molecule of glucose, C6H12O6. So as you can see, in one molecule of glucose, you are having 6 carbon atoms, correct? You have 12 hydrogen atoms, correct? And you have 6 oxygen atoms. So this is the basic picture. If you have one molecule of glucose, you have these much number of atoms, you have 6 carbon atoms in it, you have 12 hydrogen atoms in it, and you have 6 oxygen atoms in it, correct? Now, instead of one molecule, if I write Na molecules, if I write Na molecules of glucose, C6H12O6, tell me how many carbon atoms it will have? Yes, very good, 6 Na. One more thing, this is my unique way of writing this. This means that one molecule glucose have 6 carbon atoms. This is not equal, this is equivalent. So one molecule glucose contains 6 carbon atoms, it contains 12 hydrogen atoms, and it contains 6 oxygen atoms. This is my way of writing this thing. Okay. So if I have Na molecules of glucose, it will contain how much? It will contain 6 Na carbon atoms, correct? It will contain 12 Na hydrogen atoms, and it will contain 6 Na oxygen atoms, correct? Now, as you all know, Na is basically mole. So if you have written Na molecules of glucose, that means it will be equal to 1 mole glucose, C6H12O6, correct? This is C6H12O6. This will be equal to, that means 1 mole glucose will contain 6 Na, can be written as 6 mole carbon, correct? 12 Na can be written as 12 mole hydrogen, and it will be written as 6 mole oxygen atoms. So this is our very, very, very important result. As you can see, this glucose molecule was having 6 carbon atoms, 12 hydrogen atoms, and 6 oxygen atoms. And now if I take 1 mole glucose, it will be having 6 mole carbon, 12 mole hydrogen, and 6 mole oxygen. So I can make it as a rule, as a general principle, that the number of atoms in a molecule, the number of atoms in a molecule is always equal to number of moles of those atoms in 1 mole of that molecule. Are you getting my point? The number of atoms in a molecule are always equal to the number of moles of atoms in 1 mole of that molecule. For example, if you have 1 mole H2SO4, then in 1 mole H2SO4 there will be, yes, very good, there will be 2 mole hydrogen atoms, there will be 1 mole sulfur atom, and there will be 4 moles of oxygen atoms. Are you getting my point? So instead of 1 mole, let's say I have 5 mole H2SO4. So if I have 5 mole H2SO4, then I will be having, yes, very good, 10 mole hydrogen atoms, I will be having 5 mole sulfur atoms, and I will be having 20 moles of oxygen atoms. You should speak with me, you should, because that will basically do two things. One, your focus will not go anywhere. You will be focused only in here when you will speak with me. And second thing, obviously, you will learn the concept. Okay, so instead of, let's say, 5 mole, I have 0.2 mole H2SO4. If I have 0.2 mole H2SO4, that will be having, yes, 0.4 mole hydrogen atoms. It will be having 0.2 mole sulfur atom, and it will be having 0.8 moles of oxygen atoms. So in this way, we can relate moles of a compound with the moles of atoms present in it. And that gives me a new method to calculate number of atoms, to calculate mass, to calculate moles of a given element in a given compound. See this, you have 0.2 mole H2SO4. Now I can do three questions from here. First question, I have to calculate number of atoms of each type. So as 1 mole H2SO4 contains 2 mole hydrogen, 0.2 mole H2SO4 will contain 0.4 mole hydrogen. So if you have to calculate number of hydrogen atoms, then what you have to do is simple. You have moles. Moles mean Na. Mole means Na. So the number of hydrogen atoms will be equal to 0.4 Na. Finished. Let's say you have to calculate mass of hydrogen. What you have to calculate? You have to calculate mass of hydrogen in 0.2 mole H2SO4. So what you will do? You have moles of hydrogen. To get mass, you have to multiply it by molar mass. So mass of hydrogen will be equal to 0.4 grams. Correct? See here, you have 0.2 mole sulfur. That will means you will have 0.2 Na sulfur atoms. Correct? If you have to calculate mass of sulfur in here, what you will do is you will multiply it by its molar mass, 32, and it will be equal to 6.4 gram sulfur. Similarly, you will be having 0.8 Na oxygen atoms. And if you have to calculate its mass, you have to multiply it by 68, and it will be equal to 12.8 gram oxygen. Correct? So this is the important method. By using this, it's the same. Like, you can do all these questions by this method. And as this method will involve other things also, so I would recommend you to learn this method, to use this method. When you start using it, you will get comfortable in it, and you will be easily solving questions. Once you are comfortable with this method, you can solve the questions verbally like this. I can go reverse also. As we have done this question, you can come to this question now. You have to calculate mass of CO2, which contains 3 into 10 to the power 23 O atom. So we have already covered two methods to solve this question. Now we'll be covering another method, this method, to solve the question. So focus, you have 3 into 10 to the power 23 atoms of oxygen. Okay, tell me, can you calculate moles of oxygen atoms from given number of atoms? Yes. So what we'll do is we'll calculate moles of oxygen from here. How? Given number of atoms of oxygen divided by Na, 6 into 10 to the power 23. So this will be equal to half mole. Correct? 0.5. Now you'll do what I have taught you here. What you'll write is, you see, if you have one molecule of CO2, it will contain two oxygen atoms. Correct? So whatever is the number of atoms, same will be the number of moles of atoms. So if I have one mole CO2, that will contain 2 mole oxygen atoms. Correct? Now comes the part. If 2 mole oxygen atoms are present in 1 mole CO2, then 1 mole oxygen atoms will be present in half mole CO2. Correct? If 1 mole oxygen atoms are present in half mole CO2, then you have half mole oxygen atoms. What you have? You have half mole oxygen atoms. So half mole oxygen atoms will be present in half into half mole CO2. It's a simple unitary method. 2 mole oxygen atoms in 1 mole CO2. 1 mole oxygen atoms will be present in 1 by 2 mole CO2. So half mole oxygen atoms will be present in 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, which is 1 by 4 mole CO2. And from moles of CO2, you can calculate mass of CO2 as 11 grams. So this is your correct answer, 11 grams CO2. So from all the three methods, answer is same. But now, from now onwards, you should use this method, you should understand this method, you should practice this method, because this method is going to help you a lot in the coming questions of this chapter or even other chapters also. Okay, you copy this, then we'll start practicing different varieties of questions on this type of concept.